Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we'll define what we mean by cross-coupling reaction. Across the top of the screen is a very simple reaction. As written, the reaction implies that we have some kind of organic halide, X equals a halogen, reacting with some kind of organometallic, M equals a metal, in the presence of a catalyst to make a new carbon-carbon bond, the bond between the R and R prime groups, and a metal halide salt. The catalyst is typically some kind of transition metal, and the solvent really varies. THF, DMF, toluene. These are all common examples. This is a common model for a cross-coupling reaction. As you might imagine, this model allows a lot of different reactions to be considered as cross-coupling reactions. For our purposes in this playlist, we're going to have, let's say, two restrictions. One, we're mostly going to focus on reactions that connect one aromatic ring to another. So R and R prime equal aromatic rings. These are called biaryl couplings. So the R prime product is called a biaryl. One coupling partner will be an aryl halide, like something like bromobenzene, and the other mostly will be an aryl metal. So restriction number two, the transition metal will be palladium. And the form of palladium we'll use is palladium chloride, PdCl2. There are literally dozens, if not hundreds, of forms of transitional metal catalysts using coupling reactions. Palladium is the most common metal. Honestly, palladium PdCl2 is not the most common form of palladium, but at this introductory level, I do not want to get into the many details of the transition metal catalyst. I will note that nickel is more and more frequently used in these reactions. It's cheaper than palladium and is taken from the same column group as palladium. So these two restrictions together still give us many reactions to learn as cross-coupling reactions. Three reactions, the Nagishi, the Stille, and Suzuki couplings fit these restrictions perfectly. We'll also cover the Sanagashira and the Buchwald-Hartwig couplings. These last two don't quite fit the first restriction, but are still very common and useful coupling reactions. So the cross couplings we will discuss generally involve connecting two aromatic rings and require a palladium-based transition metal catalyst.